Hello everyone, we are from Soka Senior High School, and we have been studying nuclear issues to get closer to our goal of building a peaceful world. At last year's CIF, our seniors created a card game to consider nuclear disarmament, with each player representing a nation state. Feedback provided at CIF suggested it is effective as an introduction tool to encourage many youth to acquire basic knowledge about nuclear weapons and to change their attitude. In addition, the survey results show that using the card game made it easier to tackle difficult issues. Building on those advantages, as we broaden the object of verification of the card game and explore the educational vision we should aim for, we finally came to the conclusion that our goal of education about nuclear weapons could be achieved by combining the card game with other educational methods. Thus, our theme for this year is Nuclear Issues Education for Japanese Junior and High School Students. Through this education, we want our students to be able to have an informed opinion about nuclear weapons. And the ultimate goal is that students will be able to take action for nuclear abolition based on their understanding of different opinions. So why do we need to permeate the idea of nuclear issues education, and what is an effective pedagogy to reach the target? Let us start our presentation.
Why are nuclear issues important in the first place? Today, the world is facing a variety of problems that are being addressed and solved by UN organizations and nonprofit organizations every day. For example, the United Nations has set up SDGs, and many organizations have been working to resolve environmental issues, poverty, gender gap, and conflict issues, right? However, few organizations are actively trying to solve nuclear issues. Furthermore, nuclear issues are so serious that it can nullify these problems. So we must work toward a solution now. The reason for this is the damage scale of nuclear weapons. In Hiroshima, 300,000 people were killed by a single nuclear bomb. Hiroshima was turned into a deadly wasteland, and 70,000 of those who died are still unidentified. Although it's been almost 100 years since this incident happened, still there are so many things that we can't know. This fact shows us how cruel the bomb was due to the complete devastation caused by nuclear weapons.
And the nuclear weapons of today, which are far more powerful than those dropped at the time, had a part of reiterate entire civilization that people have built up to this point. In addition, those who are not killed by nuclear weapons must continue to live with the painful after effects of the bombings. And even now, 77 years later, the disabilities remain with them from generation to generation, just as they did with the Hibakusha in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. It's inhumanly beyond comparison to other weapons. During the Cold War, the conflict between the US and the Soviet Union was based on the safety myth that possessing nuclear weapons would deter the other side. Today, however, the notion is crumbling. As you can see, in the current war between Russia and Ukraine, there are statements by Vladimir Putin suggesting the use of nuclear weapons. We are now living in a world where there is indeed possibility that nuclear weapons might actually be used, and there is growing interest and concern about nuclear weapons on the issue.
In addition, when we look at the current status of nuclear abolition in Japan, the number of opportunities to learn about the tragedy of nuclear weapons through people who experienced the actual bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki is decreasing due to the decrease in the number of storytellers who have been able to tell their stories. In this context, it is extremely important to educate the next generation about nuclear weapons. In particular, junior high and high school are very important times for the development of the mind, and it is also an important time when more young people than college students can learn about nuclear weapons equally. If we can expand the sense of ethics and values through nuclear issues education at this time, we can expand the understanding of the inhumanity of nuclear weapons and the interest in nuclear issues throughout Japan. As a result, we believe that spreading awareness and understanding among many people is one step toward a solution.
While Japan is the only country in history to experience atomic bombs, there are many problems which makes it difficult to introduce nuclear issues education around Japan. For instance, there are gaps depending on the area of Japan because of the lack of an official definition of nuclear issues education. For example, some areas have advanced peace education, such as Hiroshima or Nagasaki, where nuclear weapons were dropped. There were countless victims. Moreover, it is very hard to teach about nuclear weapons since there is no right answer and standard for evaluation. It is up to the individual in how to think about nukes. Also, the tragedy itself may shock and cause trauma to students, and care must be taken when teaching about these topics. These reasons are just a small part of today's problem in Japan regarding nuclear issues education.
We made a program for nuclear issues education. It will be open to the public on the web to be used by junior or high school education, teaching nuclear issues education in the standard curriculum. By providing nuclear education in schools, every single student can raise their awareness of nuclear issues from 0 to 1 and increase their knowledge and interest. There are three elements. First, the game element. This is the element which uses the nuclear abolition card game we made. It takes 4 hours to complete. It combines an easy card game to make it easier for those who have not learned much about nuclear weapons to understand through objective and inhumane lessons. Second, the debate element. Students will do both affirmative and negative stances arguing nuclear disarmament. Debate will be held after the card game and both parts take 8 hours to complete. Third, the presentation element. In this element, the group will be asked to prepare and make a presentation. This plan will also be held after the card game and it takes 7 hours to complete both sections. This concludes the three elements in the program.
The game element is composed of 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This course is for a school that is unable to appropriate more time for nuclear issues education, but it's a great chance to increase students' interest. The composition of the debate element is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 6, and 7. By playing a Model UN, we believe we can broaden our perspectives and think of global issues as familiar problems. Also, critical thinking skills can be acquired through experiencing both affirmative and negative sides. The presentation element covers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 8. The purpose of this course is for students to engage in discussion, discussing various views on related topics with others, and to acquire presentation skills. Students will choose a theme and work in groups to achieve this goal.
There are several improvements we want to achieve in our education plan for nuclear disarmament. First of all, the time to conduct this plan is so limited. If we try to introduce it in today's Japanese schools, it is most realistic to implement integrated studies, but we must show evidence that our plan will be more effective than the previous programs, as it must fall within a specific time frame. For example, in the public school in Osaka, Akibonagawa Junior High School, a movie about a war is watched to attract interest about peace studies, and students give a presentation about peace. This method is similar to our card game, in which we introduced nuclear education and the presentation course. Using this teaching method, it is possible for schools to adopt our education plan.
The second improvement we'd like to talk about is how to convey the inhumanity of nuclear weapons to students. Hiroshima and Nagasaki received severe damage from atomic bombs, and it was so cruel. care should be taken when conveying this, because some students can be traumatized learning about the harsh facts and reality surrounding nuclear weapons. Lastly, we should indicate concrete topics or elements to develop students' writing skills. It is said that many Japanese students are not good at writing because they don't know how to write well. Therefore, students will be confused when teachers instruct them to write something with only abstract topics. Developing writing skills is an important aspect for students to express their opinion about nuclear weapons.
We explored educational methods that would enable junior and senior high school students to express their opinions about nuclear weapons based on their knowledge. However, through inquiry activities and visits to bombed cities, we have found that the subject of nuclear weapons is not very familiar in the field of education and is difficult to handle because of its power as a negative influence on students' minds. However, with a single nuclear weapon, the SDGs that we are promoting now will all go down the drain. Therefore, we emphasize that nuclear issues education is essential for Japanese junior and senior high school students who will be the future leaders to solve nuclear issues. We will continue to try to find ways to put nuclear issues education into practice based on the realities of the educational field. We would like to start by spreading our idea of nuclear issues education from Japan, the only bombed country, and eventually create an educational program that can be offered to people all over the world, transcending cultural differences and historical perspectives. Thank you for your attention.